This episode is brought to you by Rune. Click the link in the description box below for more information.
So we have terrible weather today. That means the sun might come in and out and completely wreck the quality of this footage. So if it does, I apologize in advance. Today, we're gonna go back to basics again with the Raspberry Pi. This is a single board computer. So everything on one board. Now this is a Raspberry Pi 3. It sells for about 50 bucks. On it is everything we need to turn it into a network audio streamer. So we have an Ethernet input here for Ethernet cable, there's Wi-Fi on board, and then there's a DAC chip on board which sends analog output out of here, and then we have not one but four USB outputs so we could send digital audio out of here as well. So the specific functionality of this device as a network streamer is determined by the operating system loaded onto this micro SD card. Now, on here and throughout this video, I'm using something called Volumio. And I like Volumio because it's very, very beginner friendly. It has a user interface that's not going to scare people away. It has a very good, easy to navigate setup wizard, which also makes it easy for Wi-Fi onboarding. So if you don't want to use Ethernet, Volumio is very good for that. And if you want to know how to install Volumio onto this micro SD card, you'll have to watch my beginner's guide to Raspberry Pi streaming video, because it's all in there. Because a lot of the stuff I'm talking about today presupposes that you've watched that video and you understand some of the nitty gritty of the basics of Pis as network audio streamers. Now, the other thing I really like about Volumio is that we can access it inside a web browser, so from any device on the network, so a phone, computer, tablet, whatever. And it also allows us to install plugins. So there are plugin options for Spotify, Spotify Connect, for RuneBridge, for SqueezeLite, for Logitech Media Center / SqueezeBox server. So we can vary the functionality of what Volumio can do. Now, my focus with this video is going to be Spotify Connect, because Spotify recently announced that they will be launching a lossless tier this year. So I think more audiophiles or more people who care about sound are going to take an interest in Spotify. And my aim is to show beginners or newcomers how they can do that for as few dollars as possible, or as few euros as possible. I'm going to feature some DACs in this video and talk about those, but not other DACs, because I have to make some tough choices when doing comparisons, which take several days per DAC comparison, and also when shooting and then when editing. Ordinarily, I'd put my Pi 3 into the official case like this. But today, just for the sake of showing you what's going on, I've got it running naked on my sideboard here. And this is the power. This is the 5-volt power that's coming in, Ethernet to give it network connectivity. And then I'm coming analog out into the Peachtree Nova 300's analog input. So this is as basic as it gets. I'm running Volumio, and Volumio is running Spotify Connect. So this weekend I've been playing this Rawbag Vrooma. I think that's how you say it. That's how Olaf said I should say it. And this is a DJ Mix CD. So if I click this and then click Darko Pi, I've now got a connection to my Pi. So if I click play, you're not going to hear anything because I don't want to get a copyright strike. But basically, this is the way Spotify Connect works. You play something on your phone, on the app, or on your Windows PC or Mac, and then you select the Pi as an output device. And then what the phone or the Mac does is sends the URL of that stream to the Pi. And so now the Pi is pulling it down from the cloud directly. So I can turn my phone off and the music will keep playing. That's the beauty of Spotify Connect. Also, it does gapless playback, which is great. Anyway, so we've got analog output setup going on here, and the DAC on board the Pi is doing the conversion from digital to analog. Now, this Peachtree also has a DAC inside. So instead of using the Raspberry Pi DAC, we could use the DAC inside this, which means we have to send it a digital signal. And to do that, I'm going to use USB. USB cable goes into one of the USB sockets on the back of the Pi. And then we have to tell Volumio that we've made that change. So basically to tell it that the output device should now be USB and not analog. So which sounds better, the DAC inside the Pi or the DAC inside the Peachtree? Well, for me, no contest, Peachtree wins every time. It's better separated, it has better frequency extension, and it just, it sounds clearer, more transparent. Now we don't just have to use USB to add a DAC to a Raspberry Pi. And we can do this with a Pi 3 or a Pi 4. And that is, we can get something called a HAT board. And this is a Boss DAC board from a company called Allo. But there are many, many companies that make DAC boards for Raspberry Pis. So the choice is kind of abundant, really. This one sells for about $60. Many of them are, you know, cheaper than that, some are more expensive. And what happens is that these two fit together. So the 40-pin socket here, or the 40-pin riser set here, allows us to apply the Allo socket like this. So we clip it on, and we have this like double pack here. Now what happens is that this top board then pulls the digital audio up from the base layer, and then the decoding, the digital audio conversion takes place on this board, and then these two analog outputs come out. So that's a DAC HAT added to a Raspberry Pi. And we can also use HATs to change the digital connectivity of our Pi. So inside here, I use this a lot in my videos because this is a super easy way for me to set up a network streamer without much thinking. In here is a Raspberry Pi 3 on the bottom. On top is a HAT board. But instead of having a DAC on its circuitry, what it does, like the DAC board, it pulls the digital audio up to the top floor and then outputs SPDIF coax or SPDIF BNC. So if your DAC does not have USB, or if you just simply prefer to use coax to feed your DAC, then like with this Peachtree, it has a coax input. I can then connect these two together. So now this little network streamer is feeding my Peachtree over SPDIF. It's pretty cool. So this whole thing, I think, is $180. And I think for the DAC board is $60 plus 50 for the Pi, so about 110, maybe 130 with an acrylic case. So pretty cheap relative to commercial type network streamers. some of you might be wondering about Toslink. Here is a Raspberry Pi 3 with an Audiophonics hat on the top, which sells for about 18 euros, and the case is about 4 euros. The whole thing is about 90 euros. Anyway, so this hat inside here looks just like the other hats. It's just a single board. It pulls the digital audio up from the Pi and then spits it out here in digital format. We have a choice of coax, which we've seen before with the Allo, but also here we have Toslink that we don't have on the Allo DigiOne. So that's very useful if your DAC only has a Toslink input. Let's talk about sound quality for a moment, because some of you will be wondering how this Boss DAC board sounds compared to the Peachtree. This Boss DAC, I think its strength is tone and substance. So the Peachtree DAC to me sounds just a shade thinner, but it's better separated and I think offers a greater sense of transparency than does the Boss DAC. Not to write this off, this is definitely a worthwhile upgrade over the Pi's own DAC, but doesn't quite get as good as the Peachtree DAC, not quite. But I want to talk about now some DACs that do surpass the DAC inside the Peachtree and how we can integrate those into our Volumio Raspberry Pi network streaming system. Right now, I am listening to Tricky's very, very fantastic Maxinque from the mid-90s. And this is using Spotify and Spotify connecting to the Pi 4. It says Pi 4 down here. Where is that Pi 4? Well, the Raspberry Pi 4 is in this case here. This is a heatsink case, so we don't need a fan. Just a point of interest here, USB-C, not micro USB that we get on the Pi 3. I'm using a DAC, I'm using a USB DAC here, the AudioQuest Dragonfly Red. So it is doing the digital to analog conversion and therefore feeding the Peachtree into one of its analog inputs. So now we ask, okay, is the Peachtree's DAC better than the Dragonfly or is the Dragonfly better than the Peachtree? Well, it's a pretty tightly fought race competition, although these things are never competitions, but people want to know how they compare. Basically, I think the Dragonfly Red, it probably is my favorite of all the Dragonflies because it has more get up and go. So it has the rambunctiousness of the Peachtree DAC, but the Dragonfly has the advantage in that it adds more soundstage depth. Contrasting, the Peachtree is a little bit flatter. So if there's a cymbal way off at the back, you'll hear it further rearward on the Dragonfly than you will on the Peachtree. But these are very, very small differences. Personally, I wouldn't sweat them, but some people want to know. But what about this guy? You might remember this from my iOS Android video. This is the Helm Bolt. I've got the USB adapter on here so that this can connect straight into, you guessed it, Raspberry Pi.
Thank you.
So comparing the Dragonfly Red to the Helm Bowl as Dax serving the Raspberry Pi and into the Peachtree using Spotify Connect. You might think that the Dragonfly Red would be better, but I don't think it is. Or rather, the Helm Bowl has a quality that the Dragonfly Red doesn't. And that's like it sounds more natural, more organic. It has a greater sense of ease. And for me, as somebody who listens to less than stellar recorded music quite a lot of the time, that's really important. And it's probably really important as well right now, given that Spotify is still streaming maximum 320 kilobits per second og vorbis. There is a gotcha though. With the Bowl, it doesn't have a lot of headroom. I don't know whether that's because its voltage output is not as high as the Dragonfly or because it's measuring the impedance of whatever's connected to it and then adjusting its output accordingly, because it does that with headphones when you connect it to a phone. So it might be doing that here. So if you ask me which one I prefer, Helm Bowl in terms of sound, but Dragonfly for headroom, if you need it for those quieter recordings. So if you're a classical music listener, you might go for the Dragonfly Red, but if you're listening to a lot of loud contemporary pop music or indie or dance music, then the Helm Bolt's headroom will be enough, and I think it's the better of the two DACs. So you can use the Dragonfly Red, the Helm Bolt with other devices, especially smartphones. I prefer the Bolt in that role just because it's less bulky. And then when we add them to the Pi, so this is 100 euros. This Pi with its case is about 80 euros, so 180. If we use the Dragonfly Red, this is 200 euros, so 280. So you have to work out whether that price premium is worth it for you. I can't tell you, I am not you. However, there is one other thing I want to talk about today, because this might actually change your decision about everything that's gone before. And that is this box here. This is called the Rasp DAC Mini, and it comes from a company called Audiophonics in France. It looks more advanced than what we've seen before. So basically it's a black box. I had to put my own Pi 4 inside. It did not come with a Pi. This is only for Pi 4. But it's a case, but also a DAC board inside that does the DA conversion for us, and a screen. So it's basically like a more advanced DAC hat, but with a screen on the front. Now, this sells for, so without the Pi, it sells for 180 euros. You have to build it yourself. The instructions are very clear. There's a PDF on Audiophonics' website, which is very good. Also, we have to run their custom version of Volumio. So you can't go to the Volumio website, pull that down, write it to a micro SD card. You have to use Audiophonics' special version. That's what's running here. The screen here shows us the time, the IP address of the unit, which is very useful if you're accessing it through the Volumio web interface. And also the volume setting. Now I just set the volume to 100 because obviously this is doing my volume control for me. Now Spotify Connect, I want to play some Les Savvy Fav. I want to play Inches from 2004, which is just such a great record. Pull that up, punch in the Rasp DAC Mini. So whenever I'm playing Spotify Connect, I get, you know, artist, album and track info and a progress bar and things like that. So this is pretty useful. I think it's quite a nice little feature. No, it doesn't work with Rune. It's just Spotify Connect. Anyway, the whole piece, so with the Pi, is 250-ish euros. Why would you buy this? Not just for the playback information on the screen, and not just because it's like a nice tidy solution, but also because it sounds better than any of the setups that we've covered so far today. The top end is smoother. It takes the liveliness of the Dragonfly Red and the Peachtree, adds in the Dragonfly Red's soundstage depth, but also a more natural kind of sound that we get from the Helm Bolt. So this is a fantastic sounding network streamer from Audiophonics. But the really interesting thing is that I think in many ways it sounds just as good as the Volumio Primo. I can't separate these two apart from on price, because this is like $500, I think. It doesn't have a screen. It's just a black box. And I think actually in the last week or so, Audiophonics have actually might have discontinued this model and replaced it with a version that has a color screen that sits just here, so you might get artwork. But I'll have to confirm that in the description box below. So please, I'm literally begging you, please, please, please look at the links that I give you in the description box below, because they flesh out this story. So please look at those before asking a question in the comment section. Yes, the comment section has come back. No, I am not moderating it. Somebody else is doing that for me. So if you want to ask a question, ask it of the community, please. So for me, I think if you want best value, then I would go with this Helm bolt, providing it has enough headroom for you, and a Raspberry Pi 4 in a heatsink case like this, because it's such a tidy and elegant solution, and it runs Volumio. But if you want best sound quality, so best everything, so not just best value, you would go for this, the Rasp DAC Mini from Audiophonics. Because for me, even though it's not as flexible as having a Helm bolt to hand, it does give us better sound quality than this or with the Dragonfly. This is a Xiaomi Mi Box S. I've made a video about this. It's basically a TV streamer with HDMI out, so we have a screen output, and it has a USB out, and it has a mini Toslink out, and analog output here. People might legitimately ask, well, why wouldn't I just use one of these for Spotify Connect? Because it does it. And not just through Chromecast, but proper Spotify Connect. I say proper because the difference between Chromecast Spotify and Spotify Connect is two things. Firstly, Chromecast is capped at 256 kilobits per second. And you'll also know if you're listening to a Chromecast rendition of a Spotify stream when you'd get gaps between the tracks. So if you play a classical piece or, you know, a DJ mix, like a Fabric mix or something like that, you should not hear any gaps between the tracks. Anyway, so that's my little bugbear with Chromecast. The other reason you would not necessarily use this is if you are a little bit of a purist when it comes to digital audio streams, because every digital audio stream that comes out of the Toslink output on this is resampled to 48 kilohertz by the Android operating system, just like it does on the mobile phone. So if you're playing, let's say we're listening to Spotify Connect in the future and we're playing a CD quality stream, that is 44.1 kilohertz. Actually, Ogg Vorbis is also 44.1, but I won't get into that today. But if you're playing a 44.1 kilohertz stream and you're playing it through this, it will get resampled to 48 kilohertz before being sent out of that and then into whatever DAC you're going to use. Now that resampling, depending upon how good it is, can alter the sound quality of the stream. It can, because it messes with the bits. It's what audiophiles call not bit perfect. So with our Raspberry Pi solutions, if you feed any of these 44.1 kilohertz, 44.1 kilohertz is what the DAC decodes. It's bit perfect. The other advantage of these Raspberry Pi situations is that they also do high-res audio. But given that our focus today is Spotify Connect, we're not so much interested in that. But just note that the Raspberry Pi setups are bit perfect, and the Xiaomi Mi Box S and other Android-based streamers are not. Thank you. So as you can tell, I'm a massive fan of the Raspberry Pi. Pi 3, Pi 4, doesn't really matter with these situations apart from compatibility with this box here. But what might surprise you is that a good number of manufacturers, of hi-fi manufacturers, use the Pi or the industrial smaller version inside their products. Some are very open about this, others are not. But that tells you how much they also rate the, I guess, the power of the Pi. It's a very powerful device for so little money. And I think it's fantastic that we can, you know, put an operating system on the micro SD card, boot it up, and then we've got a network streamer ready to go. And then we can build it out in whatever direction we choose, depending upon our needs, our budget, you know, even our music taste, and also whether we want portability from our DACs or not. So yeah, this won't be the last video I make about Raspberry Pi audio, because I just think this thing has so much to give. And my aim for this video is to kind of encourage you to go out and experiment for yourself. I wouldn't sweat the differences too much between these DACs. If you're thinking, oh my God, which one shall I buy? Because John said that's the best one, but that one has the best portability. Go with the functionality first. Be a functional first audiophile, if you like. And then worry about sound quality later. Because I think it's important you get experience with these things and, you know, try out Volumio, and then maybe you'll, you know, try a different operating system. That's all on you. It's up to you now to pick up the baton, and run with it. So yeah. Anyway, if you like this video, please hit the thumbs up, thumb down here. If you like my attitude towards high-end audio in that encompasses the power of the Pi, then please subscribe to this channel. And as always, thank you ever so much for watching.